We are asked which of the following functions are polynomial functions. A polynomial function is a function that is a sum or difference of monomials, which means we can define a polynomial function as a function consisting of the sum or difference of terms in which each term is a real number, a variable, or the product of a real number and variables with non-negative integer exponents or powers. Looking at number one, let's begin by determining this product. Negative 2x times 4x squared
equals negative 8x cubed.
And therefore f of x equals negative 8x cubed plus 4. Notice how we do have a sum of two monomials, and therefore f of x is a polynomial function. The first term is a product of a real number and the variable x raised to the third power, where 3 is a non-negative integer, and the second term, 4, is a real number. F of x satisfies the definition of a polynomial function, and therefore f of x is a polynomial function. For number 2, let's begin by determining the product. So we distribute x squared. X squared times 5x cubed equals 5x to the fifth. And then we have minus x squared times 2, which equals 2x squared. G of x equals 5x to the fifth minus 2x squared. Notice G of x is a difference of two monomials. Both terms are a product of a real number and the variable x raised to a non-negative integer power. So g of x is a polynomial function. For number 3, let's write the square root of x using a rational exponent. For a square root, the index is 2, and the exponent on x is 1. The square root of x is equal to x raised to the power of 1/2, which means h of x equals 4x raised to the power of 1/2 plus 9. While 9 is a monomial, 4x raised to the power of 1/2 is not, and therefore h of x is not a polynomial function. The term 4x raised to the power of 1/2 is not a monomial because while 4 is a real number, notice how the exponent on the variable x is 1/2, and 1/2 is not a non-negative integer, which means h of x is not a polynomial function. For number 4, we're given j of x equals 7 divided by x plus 3. Let's use the negative exponent property and write 7 divided by x as 7 times x raised to the power of negative 1. So j of x equals 7x raised to the power of negative 1 plus 3. Notice how this first term is not a monomial because the exponent on the variable x is not a non-negative integer, which means we do not have a sum or difference of monomials, and therefore j of x is not a polynomial function. I hope you found this helpful.